Good morning, brothers and sisters. Welcome to Morning Heart Devotion. To start off, let's offer a greeting about our heavenly parents and true parents. 천진 천부님께 경배. 바로. And now to lead us through the family pledge, I'd like to invite up Reverend Milhan Stevens.
파장맹세 1. 한여국 주인 우리 가정은 참 사랑을 중심하고 본향 땅을 찾아 본연의 창조 이상인 지상 천국과 천상 천국을 창건할 것을 맹세하나이다. 2. 천여국 주인 우리 가정은 참 사랑을 중심하고 하늘 부모님과 참 부모님을 모시어 천주의 대표적 가정이 되며 중심적 가정이 되어 가정에서는 효자, 국가에서는 중심, 세계에서는 성인, 천주에서는 성자의 가정의 도리를 완성할 것을 맹세하나이다. 3. 천여국 주인 우리 가정은 참 사랑을 중심하고 4대 심정권과 3대 왕권과 황족권을 완성할 것을 맹세하나이다. 4. 천여국 주인 우리 가정은 참 사랑을 중심하고 하늘 부모님의 창조 이상인 천주대 가족을 형성하여 자유와 평화와 통일과 행복의 세계를 완성할 것을 맹세하나이다. 5. 천여국 주인 우리 가정은 참 사랑을 중심하고 매일 주체적 천상 세계와 대상적 지상 세계의 통일을 향해 전진적 발전을 촉진화할 것을 맹세하나이다. 6. 천여국 주인 우리 가정은 참 사랑을 중심하고 하늘 부모님과 참 부모님의 대신 가정으로서 천운을 움직이는 가정이 되어 하늘의 축복을 주변에 연결시키는 가정을 완성할 것을 맹세하나이다. 7. 천여국 주인 우리 가정은 참 사랑을 중심하고 본연의 혈통과 연결된 위하는 생활을 통하여 심정문화 세계를 완성할 것을 맹세하나이다. 8. 천여국 주인 우리 가정은 참 사랑을 중심하고 천여국 시대를 맞이하여 절대 신앙, 절대 사랑, 절대 복종으로 신인의 일체 이상을 이루어 지상 천국과 천상 천국에 해방권과 석방권을 완성할 것을 맹세하나이다.
Thank you, Reverend Milhan Stevens. And now to open us up in prayer, I'd like to call on Alexa Ward.
Thank you, Respect. Please join me in prayer. Loving Heavenly Parents, we turn to you as we begin this final day of morning devotion with our beloved Regional President, Dr. Chung Sik Yong. Heavenly Parent, thank you for this precious time, this personal journey with you that has touched our lives in so many ways. For me personally, I feel your living presence every day during morning devotion. Some point, a few points that you wanted to share with me, points that have become a part of me, that everyone is a child of God, that every problem in the world is a reflection, a continuation of the initial fall between Adam and Eve, that we can take responsibility for the problems of others, that your love can grow and flow through us, that if we sincerely do our 1% or 5%, then you can do your 95 to 99%. So much blessing in our lives. So what can we do to show our appreciation, to pay this forward? My mind and heart turns to our beloved True Mother. During the recent time in Korea, which I watched online with my husband, I could feel her heart toward you, her desire to comfort you, Heavenly Parent, to fulfill your wishes, to dry your tears. As directions and changes began to come from Korea, I realized, I understood that the most important thing to do now is to trust True Mother and deeply connect to her heart, to trust her in such a way that you can fully work through her. Dr. Yong, don't worry about us. Together we can meet this challenge. Because of you, we will meet this challenge. Godspeed as you travel to Korea and begin your new mission. We will be with you. We send all of our love with you. I report this in the names of Thomas and Alexa Ward. Bless Central Family. Aju.
Aju, wow. Alexa Ward, thank you for your beautiful prayer. Oh, Thomas Ward, thank you so much for your couple's dedication and supporting morning devotion. 감사합니다. See you very soon. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Aunt Alexa, for opening us up with such a beautiful, powerful prayer. And that we're going to go into our breakouts to share gratitude. So just take a moment to think deeply, just reflect on all the gratitudes, possibly for 2.5 years, and share with whoever you paired up with. And we'll be back here to share with everyone else. See you all in 7 minutes. All right. Welcome back, everyone. Welcome back. Yeah, I had a great sharing with Koji Morimoto and the Saunders couple. So first, I'd like to invite up Koji. Koji-san to share with us his gratitude this morning.
Good morning, Dr. Yong and all the brothers, sisters. And my appreciation is this morning devotion and with Dr. Yong and God, brothers, sisters. We start from appreciation. And we need to think about appreciation every day in the 10 times, 10 things. And then now we close with appreciation. This morning devotion. And I remember that Dr. Yong said that God will understand start intellectually, and then next understanding the heartistically, and the next understanding more heartistically. And now I understand what is more heartistically is, I don't want to leave from you. This is God want to create. Mm. I don't believe with you, Dr. Yong. Mm. I believe everybody thinks this way. Mm. You made a God's dream. You made a God's heart in this community. Mm. I'm really thankful. Thank you, Dr. Yong.
Mm. Ah, Koji Morimoto-san. 本当にな、今二人があの GPA で頑張っているので、よう嘘立てて、必ず祝福を受けて、そうするようにね。本当に子供のためにたくさん先生を作ってくださいね、小路さん。うん。いつもありがとうございます。本当にね、自分の子供たちも、本当にモーニングディボーションも、自分の仕事も、いろんな面で、一つのモデルじゃないかと、そのように思っています、小路さん。頑張ってよ。ありがとうございます。
感謝無理だ。うん。
Thank you. Thank you, 小路さん。Next, I'd like to invite up the Saunders couple to share with us their gratitude as well.
Well, I'm grateful to God to be alive and to have a heart and to be able to pray and thank Him and communicate with our Heavenly Parent. So that's my gratitude.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, thank you, Dr. Yong. Thank you, Resford. Morning, brothers and sisters. Yeah, I'm grateful to Heavenly Parent, to Jesus, to True Parents. I'm grateful for Dr. Yong's continued efforts getting up very early morning every day and preparing for morning devotion. I do a lot of presentations and lectures and webinars, and to prepare for one once a week,takes a phenomenal amount of effort. To do it every day is just off the chart. So thank you, Dr. Yong, for that devotion. I think I'm also very grateful for all these morning devotions, all the staff, for Resford, how much he's matured in these years. And I'm also very grateful, Dr. Yong, I think,The restoration of America, Korea, and Japan will come through heart-centered leadership that's reunited with True Mother. Mm-hmm. And I think that's what you have done. I think your vision of being able to incorporate not only education through divine principle, but other forms of education like Heavenly USA, and we've seen some of the results of that, and that can be even multiplied much more.Service learning, sports, character education. And I think we have to be able to do it from a lot of different ways. Also, I'm very grateful for your understanding of being able to send out the GPA members internationally. I believe every young American, young Australian, European needs to spend 3 years between 17 or 18 years of age and 21 before they go to college.So that they can grow up and find out who they are. Because right now in America, 60% of college students are are not graduating. So we're only graduating 40%, and it's because they don't know who they are.
Oh, yeah.
They need to find their identity. And if they go out, from my experience of sending out young people internationally, 99% had life-changing experiences and have gone on to have successful careers. And I know all the parents on this call will say, well, they'll lose all their momentum. They don't have any momentum. They lose it in the final year of high school anyway, and they lose it more in college. They get blown away. But when they come back as the GPA members are now, they will be able to be more successful. Yeah. And finally, I think I'm grateful for your ability to be able to bring all the different organizations together. Mm-hmm. We are the unification movement, but we're probably one of the most segregated organizations that I've ever worked with. And everybody is very strong-headed, and that's really good. But we have to be able to go beyond our ego and pride and learn to respect different organizations and work together. But I think it all comes from leadership, and I think you've been able to provide that heart-centered leadership and that devotion. And then based on that, I think a lot of those barriers can be broken down. And I think it's the American ministers that are going to save America with strong leadership, and the second gen who are maturing a great deal, and then the first gen as coaches and mentors and supporters. So that's my sharing for today.
Yeah, thank you so much, Alan, Sandra, and June. Thank you so much. I really regret I need to, I supposed to have more time to work together with you, especially character education. I love your character education actually so much. You know, when I was in Asia, I had a chance to hear your lecture. My regret is how you utilize your such kind of capability and ability to teach to young people. I'm so regret. And then, however, I agree with you that we need to raise up young people. I go to Korea. I really encourage our second generation and young generation how they join the GPA and then really can be a really as the one of the global youth organization. So that is one of the my really target and goal to raise up young people. Thank you so much, Alan Sanders. For me, your couple is too much really precious to me. Thank you. God bless you, June and Alan Sanders. 감사합니다.
Thank you, Saunders couple, for sharing with us your gratitude. And thank you for starting this gratitude culture, Dr. Yong. I'm sure this will continue to live on and on. Something so simple can open our hearts and our minds every single day. And with that, we're going to go on to our final message, morning devotion. So let's open our hearts and minds to receive it from Regional President, Dr. Chonshik Yong.
안녕하세요. Good morning. Good morning. My dear brothers and sisters, clergy and ambassador for peace, 안녕하십니까? Maybe not need to hear this kind of the shouting greeting from now on, right? Today is my last morning devotion. Today's morning devotion concludes with episode 941. 941 in Korean, Korea, we say 구사일생, okay? 구사일, again, 941, 구사일생. 941 in Korea also means a narrow escape from death. You know, because of COVID-19, you know, many difficult situation. I think really we work together, put our jongsong together. Finally, we get out from that kind of a really dark tunnel. I think American movement have the great turning point from now on, centering on new leadership. I sincerely thank Heavenly Parent and true parents for protecting and guiding me for 941 days. Also, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to the interpreters who helped me a lot, to those who translated the sermon, and to all the staff at the headquarters. Special thanks to my beloved person, Dr. Michael Kiley. I really, really love him. Now he's a little bit sick in the hospital now. Please pray for our Dr. Michael Kiley. Above all, I would like to thank over the world centered on the United States. Today, I'd like to talk about the cornerstone of the culture for an ideal world of the peace from True Mother's Anthology, Volume 2. Let's start.
The cornerstone of the culture for an ideal world of peace. Originally, God wanted to see the fulfillment of the ideal of creation in the parenthood of Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve as loving children and eventually as loving parents to their own children would have been the model of a loving family centered on God. Such a family would have been the building block for an ideal world of love and peace. But the Bible tells us that God's ideal of the family was lost due to the fall of Adam and Eve. Tragically, with the loss of this first family, the potential for the realization of an ideal nation and world was also lost. So then, how can we work to reclaim the ideal of the family? My husband and I believe that women must take the leading role. We founded the Women's Federation for World Peace in 1992 to inspire women all around the world to take responsibility for their families, communities, and nations. Working in concert with the Federation for World Peace, the Women's Federation for World Peace has been working to educate men and women in the areas of politics, religion, arts, and science to become role models as loving husbands and wives, fathers and mothers, and community leaders.
Thank you, my heavenly honey, for your incredible investment for Morning Devotion 941 episode. I think you are the one who really contributes so much, actually. And then everybody remember your beautiful voice. And then really, really, I do not know how do I express my gratitude to Heavenly Honey and also your husband also supporting. Once again, thank you so much. Today, we will have the time to listen to the testimonials of the five sub-regional leaders. I pass to our MC, Resh Fred. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Yong. And before we go into our testimonies from our sub-regional leaders, actually we have our final living testimony as well, and sharing it today from New Jersey, we have Reverend Carol Povance.
Good morning, brothers and sisters, Dr. Yong.
Okay, Carol, yeah.
This morning, I want to share my living testimony, but also I want to share how Dr. Yong has impacted my life over the past 2.5 years. First of all, I need to give a background on me. Let me simply say that I struggle sometimes with taking direction. Go out to do the blessing, become a tribal messiah. Yes, I want to give the blessing. I live in my hometown, Nutley, New Jersey, and I want to give the blessing to my entire hometown. In fact, I want to give the blessing to the entire state of New Jersey. I've been praying about this for a long time, and God has inspired me, but it's been slow, and sometimes I lose confidence, and I feel maybe I'm wrong in my approach. But when I look at Dr. Yong, he encourages me because I see in him one individual who has affected so many, many lives. The amazing thing to me is that Dr. Yong has done this by simply being Dr. Yong. That has been the way he witnessed to us. That's how he touched our lives, by simply being the best expression of himself, being the word, being his own unique expression of God's word. The first time I met Dr. Yong was on an online phone call. And as I think back of that first encounter, I feel rather ashamed. I remember sharing with him the many things that I thought was wrong with our church. And Dr. Yong just listened to me and he absorbed all my criticism. And when I got off the phone, I must confess, I felt defeated. and deflated. Upon reflection, I realized that I had given absolutely nothing positive to him. All I had to give was complaint. My next encounter with Dr. Yong was at a breakfast meeting at the Clifton Family Church. Again, I sat there with a critical eye. And at the end, he asked if anybody had questions. My hand shot up immediately. And I said, Dr. Yong, I don't always like to do things the way other people do. What do you think about that? That's paraphrased. And Dr. Yong thought for a moment. And then he said very, very sincerely, the most important thing for you to do is to respond to the inspiration that God gives you. Follow God and follow your own conscience. Basically, he was telling me to become an owner, to own my inspiration and to take responsibility for the mission that God placed in my heart. And that mission in 2018, I rallied a group of people in my hometown to declare Nutley, New Jersey, an international city of peace, according to a UN-sponsored NGO known as International Cities of Peace. That means that this group that I gathered and I determined and declared not that our city is an expression of peace, but that we are determined to become an expression of peace. In 2019, the national leader of Honduras and I declared together Tala Honduras, Honduras is my lottery nation, an international city of peace. And then finally in 2020, during the World Summit, I accompanied my guest, Fred Armand, the founder of International Cities of Peace, to Pochon, South Korea, to declare Pochon, a city on the border of North and South Korea, an international city of peace. One of the first things that we did in my hometown was to create, as a community, a 5-by-20-foot sculpture of the word unity, which was eventually filled with personalized rocks which were written on and decorated by community members and students with the expressions of hope for peace. This was done outdoor during the pandemic. Our church community came out in support to paint, to entertain during the 4 rock painting events, and finally to dance and entertain at the dedication ceremony. Eventually, the mayor of the Honduran city that I was working in traveled up to Nutley, New Jersey to take part in a sisterhood ceremony for the unity of North and South America. I met Dr. Yong one more time. I shared that I felt a little bit stuck because I thought that I was confident that I was teaching the principle through my activities, but also I felt that it was slow and I wasn't proclaiming true parents and the principle directly. And then he told me, don't worry about proclaiming to everyone. Find 3 spiritual children as your John the Baptist figures, and then you will have the foundation you need to advance and multiply. Of course, I thought that's the principle. Why couldn't I think of it myself? The unity sculpture that we erected in my town is like my temple, a symbolic expression of God's calling to me. Now, I'll strive to substantiate that calling by bringing my town into unity with God and then bringing my state into unity with God. This is my declaration today. Dr. Yong, I don't think there is a greater compliment that a child could give to his or her parent than to say, I want to be like you, nor any greater compliment to a leader than to have a follower say, I want to be like you. Dr. Yong, you have won our hearts by being the best expression of Dr. Yong. And you know what? I want to strive to be like you and become the very best expression of myself. I want to win the hearts of people by being the unique expression of God's word that I am meant to be. Words can't express the gratitude I have in my heart for the patience and love that you have shown to all of us. You did not criticize me for complaining or thinking differently. You took me from where I was, offering grace and forgiveness for my shortcomings and encouraging me to follow my dream. And for that, I am truly grateful. The following is a short video montage of my work. I should restore some for you.
my goodness, what a beautiful testimony, Carol. Carol, I love you so much, actually. And also your husband, and then one of my happiest time to meet you and your husband together. It was a really incredible and beautiful moment. You are not a negative person. You are very, very sincere person. I think in your life, you've done so many things, but I'm so sorry I could not recognize your achievement so well. But today, I deeply moved by your sharing. Anyway, Carol, let's keep in touch. Thank you so much. God bless you, your journey. Please break through 3 spiritual children.
Yes.
Carol, thank you so much. 감사합니다. I love you.
And me, you.
Yeah. Thank you for such a beautiful, beautiful testimony on Carol. I remember when that happened. It was amazing. Thank you. And with that, we're going to go on to our sub-regional director's testimony, the people who worked very closely with Dr. Yong all throughout the past 2.5 years. So we're going to start from 5, and I'd like to welcome up sub-regional director, or you could say directors of Region 5, Kevin and Masako Thompson.
Good morning, Dr. Yong.
Kevin finally came back from Japan. No news is good news.
All good news. Good morning, brothers and sisters. This is my first time at 3 a.m. in the morning. It's my first and last time. So Shakespeare said, parting is such sweet sorrow. So we're sad to see you go, but we're happy to see you go to Korea, Dr. Yong. When you first came to America, I told you that I wasn't happy. I wasn't happy to have another Korean leader. And I told you, I struggle with Korean leaders.
Oh my God.
And you told me, so do I. And I thought, wow, this guy won my heart already. So you restored my faith in Korean leaders, Dr. Yong. You know, Dr. Yong, you went on a 50-state tour because you really wanted to love America and you wanted to follow in two parents' footsteps. And you went to places like Boise, Idaho, Billings, Montana, Bellingham, Washington, Salt Lake City, Utah, and you touched the hearts of brothers and sisters all over this country. And for that, I really am grateful that, you know, you didn't just stay in New York or New Jersey, but you went all over the country. And my wife and I were fortunate enough to travel to 11 states together with you. And my conclusion, brothers and sisters, is Dr. Yong is the real deal. He's not a fake. He's not saying one thing and living a different way. When you're with somebody day and night for a long time, you get to see what they're really like. And I saw that Dr. Yong, he never complained. He never complained about the accommodations or the schedule or the food. And even though the word got out that Dr. Yong really likes salmon, so everywhere he went, there was salmon. So he told me this is really the salmon tour for peace. Dr. Yong, you taught us how to upgrade our love. No matter where you went, you had one thing on your mind. How could I love these brothers and sisters? And I really appreciate it, the example that you showed. And we went to Alaska together, and Dr. Yong slept through a major earthquake. There was an earthquake and he slept through the whole thing. There was sirens going off and everybody was told to get to high ground, and you know, because a tsunami might be coming. But Dr. Yong slept through the whole thing, and the next morning he came out for morning devotion and he's like, did something happen here last night? Yeah, just an earthquake, you know. And I realized that Dr. Yong had already created a heavenly tsunami across America that was really shaking up the American unification movement and connecting us all together in heart. Mm-hmm. And he was showing the Jungsung that touched every single one of us and taught us all how to upgrade our relationship with God and true parents and with each other. So, Dr. Yong, everything you did in America has been touched by God and really powerful. So I have no doubt that you will be a success in Korea because you found the winning formula. The winning formula of, you know, do lots and lots of jungsung. Do more jungsung than anybody else and love Korea more than anybody else and hug as many people as you possibly can. What could possibly go wrong? So, Dr. Yong, I want to encourage you to bring your VIPs to Alaska for fishing. Mm-hmm. We will wait for you there. And on behalf of my couple, the Thompson family, and all brothers and sisters from Subregion 5, I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you. God bless you.
Wow, Kevin, thank you so much. How about Masako?
Hi, Dr. Yong, thank you so much. I'm so grateful to get to know you more personally with the tour, and also Mrs. Yong, and really such a lovely person. I'm so grateful to get to know her. And we are so grateful we offer morning devotion with West Coast, and more brothers and sisters can attend and can hear from you and God's word. And I'm so grateful, and I just say thank you. Thank you for restore my husband, Unity, who is Korean leader. That was yeah, thank you so much. So many things you taught to us, and I've learned a lot from you. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I win over Kevin Miss. I win over America. Kevin, and when I heard about your testimony, your prison life, actually I cried a lot. I really deeply appreciate your such kind of the loyalty toward God and true parents. I never forget that. Even my wife also shares same kind of feeling. And you brought me three books. So now I already put somewhere, I think definitely they will make it. They, after they reading your testimony, prison life, they were so moved. Now it is not easy time, but definitely we'll make it. I really admire by your absolute loyalty toward God and toward parents and your leadership. So many brothers and sisters experience of the revival and resurrection. I hope you can do more than before. I really love you. Yeah, how can I find a way to really John the Baptist figure to go to Alaska? I love Alaska. You know, we already planned to go to Alaska, but my mission already changed. My goodness. Someday I will call you to go to Alaska together. Once again, thank you so much, Kevin and Masako, for beautiful support and dedication and always care of me. Kamsahamnida, Kevin, Masako, and Subregion 5, all leaders and members. Kamsahamnida, thank you.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend Thompson and Mrs. Thompson. And next, we're going to go on to Subregion 4. We're going to hear from Dr. John Jackson.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Dr. Yong.
Hey, John.
Oh, my goodness. 941 days, Dr. Yong. That's got to be a world record or something somewhere. I mean, we might ought to do the count. I've told you before, the first time I heard about morning devotion and what you're planning to do for the next 7 years or something, I thought, okay, I'm going to watch and see what happens here. And I have, and I don't know. I've never seen anybody do anything like that, sir. I've never seen anybody with that kind of determination, that kind of grit, that kind of just sheer will to, once you start something, never give up. That alone is what people say the most successful of us all are made of. you can, you know, graduate with the highest honors and be a quitter. You can, I mean, you can be so smart and not really follow through with your plans, but that's one thing you're not guilty of. You've actually accomplished something quite remarkable, and I'm so moved and inspired by it. I was trying to think of what you are, and you are truly a son of God. You gave so much to the members when you came to Subregion 4. We were in the middle of a pandemic, and you were hugging every living child and every soul. The one thing people know, you know, you don't hug children. They're like, you know, snot balls, and they get full of germs, but you hugged everybody. And I would literally have to say, no. And Dr. Yong would look at me like this and still hug the next person. I was like, oh my God, this guy's crazy. But it's the kind of crazy that made people fall in love with you. And that's the other thing. You made people feel loved and cared for genuinely. And those little hugs that you gave all across America, and those little envelopes of little extra love that you gave all the children. You know, how many children do we know that have negative thoughts and negative things and negative experiences because someone came and, you know, said something rude or harsh or difficult. And the next thing you know, these kids, their only experience was just, wow, a total stranger gave me a gift. Wow. And that was what you were giving people all across America. You were giving people probably the most important gift, which is, you know, love of some, you know, they don't know you personally. And when you are just giving them the kind of love that true parents have. And that was just amazing. You also, you know, you gave people like Louise Honey. You gave Louise Honey her voice. I mean it. You gave her voice forever. I will relate that woman's voice to the word of God. Man, that is amazing. And I'm really impressed by that. Your work ethic is probably I never seen anybody. I'm really impressed with work ethics today. I don't see a lot of it as much as I'd like, and some, or what I see, I'm not so impressed with, but your work ethic is amazing. Amazing. We could all learn so much from your work ethic. You, brothers and sisters, I traveled with Dr. Yong too. And one thing I noticed about Dr. Yong, morning devotion, he was devoted to morning devotion. Like, it's not something that just happens in the morning. Dr. Yong has to work on morning devotion every day for hours. And I know other people helped him with morning devotion, but it could not have been done had he not been totally devoted to make it happen. So your work ethic was a mind blower. And also you trusted me. I've always told people how you know you're being loved by someone is when they trust you with responsibility. And you trusted me. And you trusted me to partner with ACLC and Dr. Rouse, and you trusted me to lead them, and you trusted me when I came to you and I had ideas to pursue certain things, and you trusted me, and I could feel that it was real, and I very much appreciate you for that. And you touched the lives of people all across the country. You've touched so many people's lives, and I've heard many, many times how much you've helped people who didn't know Father, never met True Father, have a relationship with True Father and True Father's words. Really amazing. And I love this idea of absolute sincerity touching heaven. I know it's a moving heaven because I know Father said it, but you echoed it so often, so many, many times. And I loved this also the thing that you shared about total salvation. You know, a lot of people talk about total salvation, but they wish other people to hell. You know, they condemn people all the time, but total salvation means no one's condemned and everyone's saved. Oh my God. If we would just keep our hearts clear on that, then, you know, we'd treat people differently, I believe. And you taught us that and you modeled that. And I'm really grateful for having you for True Mother sending you to us for this period of time. It was very important that you were here. And I saw how hard you were working to captivate people's imagination and help them to see beyond what we were seeing. You've impacted all of our lives, and I really appreciate you, Dr. Yong. I want you to go to Korea and be the true child that we all know that you are, and attend True Parents with all your heart and your passion like you've done here. And I'm sure you will make an incredible heavenly impact on South Korea and maybe the unity of North and South Korea. So thank you, sir.
Thank you, John Jackson. John Jackson, please do well ACLC mission. Whenever you come to Korea now, you have a church to visit.
Oh, yeah.
That is my church.
Woo-hoo.
Yeah, I really can anytime welcome your ACLC member to my church. Actually, you have very, very special talent, incredible talent and capability to relate to all Christian ministers. One thing, of course, you did many things. One thing I cannot forget. Since you came to understand the meaning of the Chonwonbun, Chonil Temple, you visited many churches and met ACLC members and then promoted the value of the Chonwonbun and talking about the donation. Wow, because of your dedication, so many people determined to donate, including ACLC minister. You are a really powerful man. You are the man of the Holy Spirit. I hope, even though I'm leaving, I think please do you all your best working together and also support to Dr. Rouse, and then really continuously you need to really revive them and to understand divine principle and to become really true parent disciples. Once again, John Jackson, I really love you and I love all sub-region 4, my dear brothers and sisters. 감사합니다, John Jackson.
감사합니다.
Thank you, Reverend Jackson. Thank you. And next, we're going to go on to sub-region 3, like here from the Takami couple.
Good morning, Dr. Yon.
Hey, Takami-san! Hiromi-san!
I couldn't imagine the last day, the day like this to come. I thought it's going to be continue forever. Well, Dr. Yon, I have learned a lot from you. And the first lesson came to my mind now is the story you told us in the very beginning. It was Reverend Johann Lee's guidance. The purpose, he said, the purpose of studying at the seminary is not to become a great leader, but to become a good person. This was the first my takeaway and from a morning devotion. And to this day, this message stick to me. And you also introduced so many other unforgettable words that taught us the essence of the unification faith, such as longing heart, chak sarang, keep going, put God your top priority, sorrowful heart of God, and the vision is the number. Life of faith is challenging and overcoming. So many. These words will stick to my head forever, I think. Thank you so much for explaining the essence in a short terms, short words. In the last 2 years and a half, Dr. Yong, you have educated us and internally renewed each one of us. At the same time, you have formed a very dynamic and artistic community like this through the morning devotion. people connected with each other like never before. For instance, during the recent Korean trip, I ran into so many familiar faces whom I didn't know before, but came to know each other thanks to the morning devotion. So now, as for the trip and also morning devotion, the 50-state tour, especially first one, was unforgettable. So it was hard work. And I have a privilege to sit next to you and visit all the states in my sub-region. The first things to do after arriving in a new city was to set up a morning devotion studio at hotel with Reverend Saul. Whenever we went, I always carried the major equipment such as 27-inch monitor and also keyboard and the stands and the backdrop. Wherever you went, I carry and follow you. That was a great, sweet memory. Mm-hmm. But I can testify, you always put morning devotion your top priority, always, even during the tour. I saw you, you know, you working on a computer in a car, traveling to state to state, because no other time is available. Dr. Yong, your total investment and your education and the artistic connection you have made will remain forever in America. So thank you so much, Dr. Yong.
Wow, 感情 高み, 本当にありがとうございます. 奥様.
Hi. Yeah. Before you came to United States, I had always wanted to have internal guidance in my life of faith. So you are the one I've been waiting for. I was so happy with when you started morning devotion with such a rich content. And also you did it every single day without missing. I was so surprised when you made recordings before you had participated in meetings or travel. It really blew me away. You couldn't make excuse. It's public mission you're doing, but you made a recording, not only one or two, three, I don't know how many you made in a day. With that incredible Johnson, I believe our spirit of, spirit of entire America really uplifted and upgraded. And another thing I really grateful for Dr. Yong, also Mrs. Yong, is that you taught us the importance of the relationship in the family, also blessing of our children. Sometimes we leave those stuff behind and focus on public mission only, but sometimes it's also not easy to make a balance, but I wanna keep that in mind. And also I appreciate you made commitment ceremony so public, not only community-wide. I think some cases nationwide or even worldwide through morning devotion. But it's really stimulate, also encourage young people to look forward to the blessing. So I truly appreciate for that. Lastly, actually yesterday I was looking at my note I took last 2.5 years. I'm remembering, Dr. Yong said this and that, but also I found out I don't remember many of them neither. So thanks to media team, also Dr. Kylie, maybe it was just 2.5 years. You are here in the US, but I believe you left us the eternal resource and also treasure. We can go back and we can study and we can practice and we can become the substance of it. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much, Dr. Yong, for your incredible, incredible hard work.
Wow, thank you, Kajio-san, Hiromi-san, for your really incredible, beautiful testimony. Wow, I know. When you moved to, you know, Chicago from the Hawaii, and I already feel that I was so happy. You are not just only from, you know, understanding about the Japanese culture, Eastern culture. You also understand Western culture so well. And also I can talk to you in Japanese more artistically. And it was really, for me, it's really an incredible moment. And then I really cannot forget your couple. Always, I really moved by your sincerity and heart. Thank you so much, Kajo, Takami, and Hiromi-san, you're hardworking. And then also say hello to the all sub-region 3, our brothers and sisters. 감사합니다. Kajo, Takami, I love your couple. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Reverend Takami and Hiromi Takami-san. Yeah. She was saying that she doesn't know how many Dokken had to record. Actually, what I remember was 6 morning devotions recorded in one day. 6 morning devotions recorded in one day was a record because he had traveled for many, many days, I believe, to Australia and then to Korea as well. And so one thing I really learned from Dr. Yong is to never make an excuse. You know, if Dr. Yong can do this for 2.5 years, you know, what excuse do we have in our own life? So thank you, Dr. Yong. And next, we're going to go on to sub-region 2. Dr. Ashil Akolate.
All right. Good morning.
Dr. Ashil!
Morning, Dr. Yong. Morning, brothers and sisters. On behalf of Sub-Region 2, I would like to share my heart and appreciation to Dr. Yong. My wife... also sent her word. She is currently driving every morning around this time. She's driving the children to school, but she's listening at this time. And she sent her love and gratitude. And she asked me to mention that she appreciates, of course, Dr. Yong, but Mrs. Yong also very much. So, when I've you know, think about you, Dr. Yong. Actually, before you, if there is the one word to really summarize you, in my opinion, is I've been thinking about this recently, is the word consistency. Consistency. Mm-hmm. And actually, before you even came here to America, for some reason, I was talking with Mr. Yoshimi Ozaki. I don't know what we were talking about, but he mentioned about your morning devotion you were doing in Thailand. Okay. And he actually was sending me some of your content. And I was even listening to you before you even came to America. In Thailand. And what I found out is that what you were sharing there is exactly the same thing when you came here. Mm-hmm. Right. And the key thing, you know, from your message for the last 2.5 years is really to convey the heart of God. Mm-hmm. Because that's the bottom line. Unless we can connect to the heart of God, anything else we do is meaningless. Mm-hmm. And unless the Bible says, seek first the kingdom of heaven. Right. So I believe that because you knew that, you really spend a lot of time trying to convey the heart of God mm-hmm. to us mm-hmm. through the morning devotion. And I remember the first 40 days, actually the first 10 days in Belvedere, you talk about the attribute of true love mm-hmm. and really conveying the heart of God through that. And you ask the question, why do we have to live for the sake of others? And I never forget that answer. No choice. No choice. Mm-hmm. Why? Because this is our essence. We really build to really live for the sake of others. That's where true happiness comes. That's where true joy comes. So that's why you really convey to us. So you are consistent and you live what you preach. I think the reason why you're able to affect many of us is, of course, the word Tupelo's work that you research and really select the key element and to affect her. But more than anything else, I fear is your own Johnson. It's your own Johnson that is really making the transformation.
Mm-hmm.
Because I believe that, you know, you have to wake up 3 o'clock in the morning, like Takami-san was saying, I've been with you, I've been, you know, driving you here and there. I've seen you, you know, taking any opportunity to really invest in preparing for morning devotion.
Mm-hmm.
That's an incredible Johnson. And you exercise. I've seen you. You never miss. At least every time I've been with you, even in Korea, you know, you walking around the stadium there. Every day, never miss. Really, you know, when we stay in a hotel, sometimes I will just go outside, see Dr. Young's walking really around, you know, the hotel. So an incredible, incredible consistency. I think that's the bottom line. If there is anything, Dr. Young, I really would like to inherit from your 2.5 years here or your morning devotion is really that heart of consistency.
Mm-hmm.
And that heart of really being genuine and offering sincere Johnson with a consistent heart. We've never changed. You know, I remember when Father passed away, True Mother offered 3 years of Johnson. Well, she mentioned that whether it rain or snow, whatever, every day she goes there and attend the True Mother, True Father. So I believe that it's that part of total attendance and really Johnson and be consistent, not unchanging, really is one that I'm inheriting from you, Dr. Yong, and that I'm going to carry with me for the rest of my life. Never change, no matter what is happening. Right. Also, Dr. Yong, I really also impressed by your filial heart toward True Parent, and especially at this time toward True Mother. When Mother calls, you respond. And no matter how difficult a situation might be, you respond. And then as I was praying about this recently, this image of True Father going, you know, to get the rice for his family. And I think they just have a child, they think about a month old, and there was a scarcity of rice, and he was looking for rice, so he told his wife that he's going to get a rice. And on near the 38th parallel, and God appeared to him and said, ask him to go across the 38th parallel to go to North Korea. He responded right away, even turned back. He knew how difficult it had been, but he went to North Korea. He answered the call and went. And we see the result today. So you're answering this call of True Mother, going to Korea for the restoration of Korea. So deeply also really want to express my appreciation and gratitude to you and really inherit that heart of filial son.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Filial son, right, of God. So, and also one thing I appreciate about Dr. Yong is the way you acknowledge or validate other people. And you always encourage us, no matter how difficult the situation might be. And I remember one time I wrote you a letter, you know, because listening to morning devotion, and I wrote you a personal letter. And the next day, that was a morning devotion. I was very, very impressed. Wow. So this is the way you validate, you really, and it makes a huge impact on me. You may not know, I've never shared this before, but and this is the kind of heart you have. And I've been thinking about what you shared today. Anything I want to share is to inherit your heart of filial son, inherit your heart of consistency. And every day when I listen to morning devotion, I always try to pick a keyword It was a key word, and I check myself every day. Am I living in accordance with it? Because, of course, I can come listen to morning devotion in the morning, 6 o'clock until 7:30 or so, and then do something else, become completely somebody else during the day. No. So I check, am I living in accordance with this word? And many times I see no. And it really, I have to repent, you know, my relationship with my wife. You know, how many times we hear about husband and wife relationship morning devotion? Wow. But how much am I putting that into practice? How much am I growing in my relationship with my wife? How much am I growing in my really deep heart toward God? Because you convey the heart of God so much to us. That's to me really something that I always check myself with every day. I can see, I'm seeing very far away. But because consistently hearing this every day, I can see the progress. Mm-hmm. I can see the progress. I can see my heart growing. And sometimes I'm amazed myself. So thank you so much, Dr. Yong, on behalf of the Sub-Region 2. And of course, I'm sorry, my partner, Keiko Pata, would love to be here and also express the gratitude to you on their behalf, because I learned a lot and inherited a lot from them as well. You want to say thank you so much, Dr. Yong, for your investment here in America. Don't worry, we will carry on your legacy of love. Wow. Thank you. God bless you.
Thank you, Ashil. Thank you so much for your beautiful sharing. Yeah, actually, when I ask you to become sub-regional leader, of course, you need to carry on your job here and there, but really, you really accept the heaven's order. It was really incredible, and this is really unforgettable. I already talked to you that if Turumada asks you to do, then he say no choice, you need to say yes. So I think you are such a beautiful commitment and an absolute loyalty to Turumada. And since you became the sub-regional leader in sub-region 2, I can hear many, many feedback from brothers and sisters, how much you are working very hard, listening and listening and listening and substantially also helping here and there. I can see a really promising future centering on sub-region 2. Thank you so much, Achil. And you are really, really hard worker and also really taking care of our brothers and sisters very well. I am actually so much indebted to you. Thank you so much. Also say hello to your wife and our dear brothers and sisters of region 2. 감사합니다. I love you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Ashil. Yes, Dr. Yong is a man of consistency. It's almost like just a simile for his name. With that, we're going to go on to actually Mrs. Jackson. Fusai Jackson is here. She'd like to greet you, Dr. Yong. So Fusai-san, you have the floor.
Good morning, Dr. Yong.
Fusai-san.
Ohayou gozaimasu.
Hi.
Yeah, Dr. Yong, thank you so much. We really miss you. And I really are grateful for your total love towards each one of us in America and beyond to the world. I'm so grateful, and Mrs. Yong, and because I'm babysitting and I'm far from my husband, and I have many things share to Mrs. Yong, mm-hmm. even she's Australia, because I can text her. Mm-hmm. So I complain about my husband to Mrs. Yong, and we can give and take, Dr. Yong. So I love Mrs. Yong. When she was visiting Sub-region 4, we drove everywhere. Texas, Arizona, even Las Vegas. And my husband challenged her slot machine to play with. And she, oh my God, I'm in Las Vegas. the kind of, you know, sharing. We had so much fun with Mrs. Yong. I really miss Mrs. Yong, and she gave me so much guidance and comfort me, and she agreed with me at some point. And because of my husband far away, and Dr. Yong, she really misses you, so we could share with Mrs. Yong internal things so much. I was so grateful, Mrs. Yong, too. Dr. Yong, please take care of your health, and we really love you, and please come back again.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Fusai-san. You need to love your husband, by the way, no matter what.
Dr. Yong, I'm loving him more than he loves me, okay?
Okay. Thank you, Fusai-san. Kamsahamnida.
Thank you. Thank you, Fusai-san. With that, we're going to go on to our, the first MC on morning devotion, our national president, Naokimi Bushiroda.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. So, what to say? You know, past 6 days, we've been hearing so much, you know, love and appreciation for Dr. Yong. And I thought I'd change it up a little bit and share my top challenges with Dr. Yong to make things more interesting. So, you know, when I first heard that Dr. Yong was coming, and I've shared this a little bit before, I was highly concerned because we didn't really know Dr. Yong, and he was coming from Asia, and he was Korean, and America is very Western. So I remember we decided to interview Dr. Kittle, who worked with him closely. And one of the first questions we asked, all the sub-regional directors gathered, and we set up a meeting with Dr. Kittle, and people asked different questions to Dr. Kittle. How is he like? You know, I even watched his morning devotion from Asia just to try to understand who is this guy. And one of the questions I asked Dr. Kittle was, does Dr. Yong understand democracy? And because I was concerned about how America would be run. So anyway, he did come, and first thing he did as soon as he arrived was to start morning devotion. And so I was listening in online, and then soon after, you know, I was asked to be, the national president. And so I had to kind of attend live morning devotion. So yeah, I'm all good with more, you know, conditions, and I've done many conditions in the past, but having to get up early and then drive and then attend morning devotion live, I know for other members, it was a joy for them. For me, it was a struggle because it felt, this is too much Jongsong, Dr. Yong, too much. but I felt, even though in the beginning it felt, although he didn't force me to, I definitely started with a sense of duty. But over time, I think it's changed from duty to really finding a sense of joy in engaging on a daily basis. And then really growing and maturing from there as well. You know, one of the things that Dr. Yong initiated, which I'm still doing now, is the reading the EDP. And I remember when Dr. Yong first initiated this condition, I really struggled a lot. You know, I've done many Divine Principle lectures and things like that. I've read the DP like 20 plus times. So for to go back and to read again a manual, not just once, twice, 10 times, but 100 times, it just didn't make sense to me logically. But I united, and I went through it, and you know, I did get to a point where I started to find the meditative value of kind of just going through the daily act of engaging in God's word. And then I remember on my birthday earlier this year, Dr. Yong asked me to decide to take me out for lunch. And it happened to be like my close to my 99th time reading. So I quickly read the last 100th time, and I went to lunch, not just to receive lunch, free lunch, but to also offer my 100 times reading of EDP to Dr. Yong. And so I felt like I graduated to a heart of attendance, even for that moment, of not just reading out of duty and joy, but reading out of a desire to make Dr. Yong happy. So I felt like in this short time, I was able to experience the challenge of too much jongsong, but inheriting step by step from Dr. Yong, this main value that he has. The second challenge I experienced was too much love, Dr. Yong, too much. You know, every morning in after morning devotion at East Garden, he would have me join. You know, Dr. Yong really likes to be with people. I don't share the same feeling as he does, but he invited me every day for breakfast. you know, I also have my own family and I like breakfast on my own, but he invited me every day for breakfast. So I went and, but he would share, you know, they would prepare a special meal for Dr. Yong, Korean food. Everyone else would have some kind of Western food. But Dr. Yong knew that I like Korean food. So he would share from his bowl. He would ask the staff to bring another bowl. And even though it's a serving just for him, he would share half of his soup, his Korean soup, with me. And that was one of my joys to have, to share a meal in the morning with Dr. Yong. Sometimes he would give food that he does, you know, that he doesn't finish, and he would just give it to me. Even though I'm already full, he would just give me all the extra food as well. And then he would complain later that I look like Kim Jong-un. So I stopped eating as much. I had to diet down. But I did lose 10 pounds last year. So
amazing, amazing.
And part of that too much love, I think, is, you know, he's the only leader who, you know, within the first week or two, he started saying, like, my main job is to make the national leader successful. And the kind of empowerment and almost shameless promotion of me was quite uncomfortable. Many times I felt he was also really encouraging me or projecting what he hoped for me. I don't know if you felt that before, but he'd be like, now Kimmy works so hard, most hardest working person. Actually, I didn't think so. I know Dr. Yong worked harder than me, but I know he was kind of projecting, like, this is what he hopes for me. It's like, oh, he's like my able figure. Actually, I'm sure he struggled that I wasn't attending him as an able figure, but he wanted to model and encourage me to be more like what he hopes for me. Yeah, and then final challenge was too much filial piety, Dr. Yong. Too much filial piety. You know, when he first came to America, he came with great vision, his guns blazing. He was like, we are going to have national restoration, 30,000 new members, 144,000 chombo clergy couples. And, you know, it was really challenging to keep up with the vision that Dr. Yong would share every day. That's why at some point I started to share Dr. Yong with the other subregions, because I felt they need to taste a little bit of this as well. But the heart behind what I got was, it wasn't just sharing big goals, big dreams, big numbers. But the heart of why, Dr. Yong, we're sharing these vision was because of his filial piety to God and true parents. And even recently, you know, Mother had a strong, like a leaders meeting. And one of the things, of course, Mother, you know, really is serious about membership growth, but she did mention that America, she expects us to restore states, you know, several states by now. So it's not just Dr. Yong saying these things. Actually, this is, you know, God's hope for America and true parents' hope for America. And out of a heart of filial piety, Dr. Yong was responding to that. So that was a challenge, just this too much filial piety, trying to respond to and keep up with Dr. Yong's filial piety was quite a challenge. And especially this recently, even with this change, you know, without a question, as soon as the memo came out, you know, Dr. Yong announced it the same day on morning devotion publicly that he was asked to, you know, move back to Korea. And he did that out of filial piety to Mother and to your parents. Yeah, so Dr. Yong, you definitely challenged me with too much jungsung, too much love, and too much filial piety. But I hope I was able to inherit a little bit. Thank you for your patience. I know many times you had to swallow and just be patient because of my too Americanness. But thank you for your patience. We know you're going to do great things for God and true parents in Korea. And don't worry, America will be strong and will continue to grow based on your foundation. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Naokimi. You are the one who trained me so far. I think because of you, I've grown up so much. And anyway, Naokimi, not much to say, just only one word. I really, really love you. Be strong, but you need to carry on so much important mission. God has a very clear plan for you. I know someday you can be a really great and successful leader for the sake of America. I will pray continuously, no matter what, in any place, in any situation for you and also America. Once again, thank you so much, Naokimi. I truly, not just only me, even my wife, we, both of us, really love you so much. 감사합니다, 나오기미.
Thank you. Thank you, Naokimi, for sharing everything. There are many others didn't have the experience to experience with Dr. Yong. With that, actually, we don't have time for breakouts today, but it is our final morning devotion. So we're going to go into some acknowledgments of everyone who made morning devotion possible. Mm-hmm. Devotion translators, we have slide translations. This is Korean, I believe. Akio Kishimoto, Kana Oguri, Tomomi Fukuda, Inguk So. And we have our live translators, Keiko Nakama, Ayako Heller, Anna Huntington, Chiara Gray, Monica Vallejo, Marina Falcone for the Spanish team, also Stephen Boyd and Rafael Sanchez. And then among the Spanish team, once again, Ricardo De Sena. We also had it in Chinese. That's Amy Yang, Yiru Sugihara. Chinese team, Kai Meixiang, Isla Roberts, Jingan Lin, Zhou Zhen Wan. We also had French, just like we said yesterday, Pierre Borgard, Don Pierre Sona, as well as Ellie Liking, Dase, Diara, Isabel, Lauren. And as part of the MC team, you had Milhan Stevens and yours truly. You had Diane Hack, Yasutaka Ozawa. We had Rebecca Calix and Joshua Holmes. Actually, missing from here is Naokimi Ushiroda. But also joining in this on the third gear was Ricky Benning. Ricky Benning, so for joining the final couple of weeks and months. And of course, Morning Devotion would have been possible without our dear reader, Luis. Heavenly Honey. Thank you, Luis. And content summaries by Michael and Maria Kiley. Yes, that's something that immortalized on because of him. All the content summaries of PowerPoint are all available on the website because of them. Please thank him, but also pray for him. Please pray for him. Thank as well. And Morning Devotion podcast. We have Unmi Rangalos supporting us, Michael making the audio available every single day. Media team, you don't see them, but they're there. We have Alvin Gabal, we have OG McKeon, as well as Mi Young Eaton made it possible. Of course, big shout out to Tal Zora, the hardest one, of the second to Dr. Young, hardest working person in the Morning Devotion, making it possible every single day, never miss a single day, even in Korea. Thank you Tal. And actually, with that, what we're gonna do is we're going to call on the MCs to come on very, very briefly to just share one by one. Then we'll sing our final morning devotion song all together. So, Tal, if you can just spotlight everyone. And I'm going to change my background in just a second. Let's see here. There we go. So, yeah, everyone. We have Milhan, and then Rebecca is here. And so is Yasutaka. Let's see. So, Dr. Yong, we love you so much. I'll send you the background and you can join us in a second. But actually, let's just start with Milhan, because Milhan was the very first one after Naokimi.
Yeah, just Dr. Yong, I still think I'm going to wake up tomorrow and this is all just going to be a dream. it's hard to believe. But just thank you so much for your jaksarang, your longing heart. I think you really taught us the true heart of Korea and God's heart. And wherever you go, we will love you all the time.
Okay, Yasutaka.
Thank you so much, Dr. Yong. Of course, you have introduced me to my wife, and I learned that you love her so much. And so I only hope as I grow under your guidance and also under True Parents' words that I can grow my heart to love her as much as you have loved her. And of course, Dr. Yong, you have given me this incredible opportunity to grow as I MC. Every single MC days were challenging. Something was coming up. So I had to MC from sometimes Belvedere or UTS or just even in the morning of my graduation. But Dr. Yong, you've watched over me and guided me all throughout and helped me to grow. So I never complain, even in those challenging days. 감사합니다.
Thank you so much, Yasu.
Rebecca.
Thank you so much, Dr. Yong. I'm going to try not to cry. Thank you so much for your love and dedication and your constant effort. And your incredible Jongsung encouraged and changed so many of our hearts and so many of our minds, and we're all the better for it. If it wasn't for you, if it wasn't for morning devotion, I never would have met my husband, and I never would have had the chance to perform for True Mother. You made so many dreams come true for me and for so many others, Dr. Yong. So thank you for everything. It is definitely a bittersweet goodbye. But True Mother needs you. And I know you're going to do so many beautiful things in Korea. And she's going to have such a filial son next to her. So thank you so much, Dr. Yong, for everything. I love you so much. Mm-hmm. And I will be there whenever you call. So thank you, Dr. Yong.
You need to come to my church and then you perform your music. I really
absolutely.
Thank you, Rebecca. I really enjoyed your MC job so much. Thank you so much. You contribute a lot for so many brothers and sisters. 감사합니다, Rebecca.
Thank you.
Thank you. And Dr. Yong, I love you so much. I wrote down a number of things that I learned from you. I think one thing that I appreciate the most is just your lessons on perfect plus creates perfect minus. Mm-hmm. Right? It's so empowering that we can be true owners. And through being that, anything is possible. You also taught me about Jeonsung, and you are a living example of Jeonsung in your life and in our lives too. Really, morning devotion is a testament that you can't make any excuse there's no space for excuse. As long as you are determined and you're with God, anything is possible. And I believe that these last 2.5 years are truly a miracle. A miracle that you pulled off. And on this foundation, America will grow even stronger. America will have you to thank many, many, many years and decades and centuries down the line. Also, you taught me about longing heart. Also, the deep, sorrowful heart of God. And you told many, many stories. Many stories. I'll never forget the stories about your wife being your enemy. I'll never forget the story about your teacher who gave you his lunchbox. I'll never forget all these little stories that you tell us, your moments with Reverend Johan Lee. And I know that many, many years down the line, I'll be telling my children and many people about, you know, the days I spent with Dr. Yong and all the stories that you told us. So your legacy will live on for sure. I know definitely through me, my life, and also just like, you know, two other people here, through morning devotion and directly through you, I was able to find my eternal half. Anna, and I don't know if you know, but it's 40 days ago that we announced the morning devotion that we were getting matched. That was right after 900 days of morning devotion. And she's been an incredible blessing in my life, her family, herself, and it's all because of you, Dr. Yong. So thank you for that. I'll treasure that. I've said before many times, but now you're a part of my lineage. So I'll never forget you. I love you. And there's so much I want to say, but we don't have so much time left. But I see Diane here, so I'm just going to spotlight her really. Actually, her camera's off, so maybe I won't call on her. But we also heard that there is a cake. There is a cake prepared. So if we can just spotlight Dr. Yong really quickly, and we can all just sing together a final happy morning devotion to all of us. So I will play the jingle and we can all sing together. Happy morning to us. Oh my God. Thank you, Dr. Yong. It's been an incredible, incredible 2.5 years. This will be a moment in the history of the American Provident that we will never forget. We love you so much, so much. Thank you for your Jeonsung the past couple of, just the past couple of years. And I know there's not enough time for all of us to share our gratitude to you. Thank you so much, but feel free to blow it out, Dr. Yong.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, wow. 감사합니다, my dear brothers and sisters. I love all of you. Once again, 감사합니다. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Yong.
Thank you, Dr. Yong.
Congratulations on victorious completion morning devotion in America.
Thank you. But it's not over yet. We have a musical offering, our final musical offering. It's not morning devotion without a song. And singing today, we have Jim Edgerly from Boston, Massachusetts.
Incredible 2.5 years.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Dr. Yong, before that we hear the song, I just want to thank you for 941 days. It's all right here in my notebook, so you're not really leaving us.
Oh my God, James and Kino.
we're gonna be able to study and listen to the recordings again. And we thank you for all the love that you gave to our country, America. We are so proud that you're our brother and for the huge investment of love you made in each one of us and in our country. And so this last song is a song, there's been so many excellent musical offerings. I'm so honored to be able to offer the last one. This is a Civil War song. It's a song about a country divided north and south, just like Korea. The United States was divided between Cain and Abel, and we had to have a war to sort it out, which was a terrible thing. But the outcome allowed us to move forward. This is a Civil War song about a man who's actually dying, and in his last moment, he's longing for his wife. He's longing for his wife, who he will not see again. And I'd like to just mention that the banjo player on the song is my son-in-law, who was blessed in marriage to my daughter, Mika. His name's Kenny Wolfenberger, and he's also the father of our grandchild, Cora, and he's playing banjo on this beautiful song called The Last Letter Home.
Wow. Such a great singer. Wow, my goodness. Thank you so much, James and Kino, your couple. 감사합니다. Wow, beautiful. Your song is really touching my heart. Thank you. This is the final song, right? 감사합니다. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you, Uncle Jim, for closing us out with such a beautiful, beautiful musical offering. And with that, we're going to go on to our closing prayer. And we have an MC that you all know and you all love who's here, Diane Hack, to close us out.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. Sorry, I wasn't aware that the MCs were sharing. So I texted Westford, why? yeah, but anyways, before the closing prayer, I just want to say thank you. Thank you to Dr. Yong and everyone for really making, I feel like Morning Devotion is like my family, where I come and see brothers and sisters. And as an MC, I think the first thing that Dr. Yong told me when I joined the MC, he asked me, he said, Diane, where are you from? And then I said, I'm from Africa. He said, you know, God brought you in America because you have a great mission. I don't know if you remember what you said, but the moment that you said that is when I got more even power to continue my mission as a second gen. So you really made a great impact to all of us and to all of the MCs as well. So with that, please join me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Parents, True Parents, thank you for this time and this moment. that you're allowing us to be here as your children, Heavenly Parent. Heavenly Parent, we know that, of course, we can say that this is our last morning devotion, but Heavenly Parents, it's only the beginning, Heavenly Parent. And many times where we see that it is the end, Heavenly Parent, is it actually the beginning of something new that you are giving us as your children, Heavenly Parent. So as we continue this providence and as we welcome also our new leader, Damon Dunkley, we pray that we can open our hearts and that we can be able to embrace him as well as our new continental director. But as we send off Dr. Yong, please let us really keep everything that he has taught us during this morning devotion, everything that we learned, everything that we heard, so that it's not just going to vain, but it's really something that we're practicing every single day, Heavenly Parent. As your children, we know that sometimes we have our own shortcomings and we have so many things that we're not accomplishing, Heavenly Parent. And through morning devotion, really, we've learned that we are so far from the ideal, Heavenly Parent, that we are so far from being perfect, Heavenly Parent. But every single day, you are here with us and you are guiding us and you are loving us the same way that Dr. Yong loved us, even though sometimes we doubted, even though sometimes our hearts were not aligned with him, but he truly loved us with his heart and truly sacrificed even his own family being far away from them so that he can lead this providence in America, Heavenly Parents. So please let us, as our Dr. Shield said, really have this consistency continuing in our local communities, that we can be able to have this consistency and this filial heart that he has, Heavenly Parent. Heavenly Parent, as we continue this providence, we pray that you can be patient with us. We pray that we can really be able to connect with you and have this true filial heart, not just to you, but really to our true mother who's working every single day to really move this providence forward, Heavenly Parent. Heavenly Parent, please let us be children who can understand your heart and who can truly understand yourself for heart so that we can be able to move this country, move this whole state, Heavenly Parent, and really this continent of America, Heavenly Parent. So every single day that we wake up, we pray that we can have our own morning devotion in our heart, in our families, that we can be able to really remember that our families are the front line. Really remember that our families are the true source and the beginning of everything, Heavenly Parent, so that we can be able to really grow our family and move to the next level, and starting with individually in our families and the communities and expand beyond that, Heavenly Parent. But please really be patient with us again. And as we transition with all these leadership roles, we pray that we can trust you, Heavenly Parent. Heavenly Parent, the biggest thing in history was that people did not trust you. But we pray that at this time, even though it may be fuzzy, even though it may be, we may not understand what's happening, we pray that we trust you and we trust our true mother because you know best and you know the future, Heavenly Parent. And so we offer this up to you. And I pray in my name, Diane, and Ilya Hagbik, such a couple, Aju.
Aju, thank you so much. This is a final prayer. Wow, beautiful. Diane, thank you. Please do well your ministry. I want to hear good news soon or later from you. Thank you, Diane Hag, and say hello to your husband as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Diane. And thank you all for joining in this morning devotion experience. It is graduation season, and very much so, like Bill Lay said earlier, it is our graduation today. Actually, let me put on the soundtrack so we can get on the mood. Okay, so it's been 2.5 years. We've all been amazing students of our beloved teacher, sensei, master, Dr. Chunshik Yong. So at this time, if you have your cap, please move it from your left to the right. Congratulations, class of 2023. We'll now move on to greater heights. Thank you all so much. Thank you, Dr. Yong, for this incredible time. This was really a time to bring all of America together. I think America has never felt closer.
You got a doctor degree of true love. Wow, I will give you. Wow, all of you. Thank you so much, all my brothers and sisters.
Thank you, Dr. Yong. Thank you all for joining. Please feel free to join in, connect with your sub-region for any ongoing morning devotions there. I believe a lot of them are connecting to the Chunshin one, some kind of prayer. So please connect to your sub-regional director from today, from tomorrow, moving forward. So thank you all for joining. It's been a pleasure. Thank you all for just being a part of Morning Devotion. Let's continue on with this Hebaragi faith, turning to our true parents, turn to God. Thank you all. Have a wonderful, wonderful rest of your day, now and forevermore. Bye-bye.
Thank you, James Kino, Thomas Alex, Sabine, Ken Biyong, Wonsani, everybody. Thank you, Paul, Jack.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Dr. Yong. Thank you.
You're from the Suki. Thank you.